Hi, I'm Eric Green. I'm director of the National Human Genome Research Institute at the U.S. National Institutes of Health. We study genomes. A genome is all the DNA of an organism. It's sort of like a blueprint. Every living creature needs a blueprint to develop and then to operate. It turns out that here on Earth, our blueprints are made up of DNA. Now, it turns out that all the DNA of an organism, or in other words, a whole genome of an organism, can get pretty big. For example, it turns out that the human genome consists of 3 billion building blocks. The building blocks are called nucleotides or bases, but we'll just represent them by the first letter of their name. Turns out one building block has an A to start it, another one a G, another one a T, another one a C. So GATC is the way we represent DNA, and it's the order of the letters of DNA that encode all the information necessary to make a blueprint actually help an organism develop and operate. Well, human genome, 3 billion, that's a big number. If you go to represent it, you need 3 billion letters. Over the years, I have found that people really struggle getting their head around the idea of what is 3 billion letters that make up the human genomic blueprint. What does that look like? So here in this hallway, we put together an exhibit that helps to explain that. We basically decided to take the human genome and represent not all of it, because our hallway is not big enough, but just represent 1/1000th of it. So 1/1000th of 3 billion letters. And we couldn't make the letters very big. If we did, it wouldn't fit in the hallway. You can see we had to make the G's, A's, T's, and C's quite small. But represented here is precisely the sequence of 1/1000th of the human genome. And as you walk along, you can see all the GAs and Ts and Cs and their big sequence. It's actually sort of boring to look at. And that's why we represent most of this as pretty boring looking letters. And every once in a while, though, you'll see a short string of letters in another color. That's in red. What do those mean? Well, it turns out that about 1.5% of the letters of the human genome actually directly encode for proteins. Proteins are the bricks and mortars that make up our cells and tissues. Also, a group of these red sequences is sometimes called a gene. So genes make proteins. It's sort of the real workhorses of our genome. And so you can see that very few of our letters in our genome actually directly encode for protein, but those that do turn out to be pretty important, because without our genes, we really don't develop and we don't operate very well. Now, if you look at one particular gene on this particular stretch of the human genome, we highlighted that in blue to really give it a little bit of extra oomph. Turns out this is a really interesting and medically important gene. This is the gene that, when mutated in one of these red regions, causes the disease called cystic fibrosis. And so this is the famous cystic fibrosis gene. Now, we've been walking along this 0.1% of the human genome for quite some time, but we're still not done. And that's the remarkable thing about the human genome, is just how big it is. And you can see that just representing 1/1000th of it required quite a long hallway, required quite a lot of letters and quite a lot of wallpaper to sort of get up. In fact, I can tell you, if we wanted to represent the entire human genome in letters of this size, it would have required not the roughly 83 feet of this hallway, it would have required about 15.5 miles. And that we weren't going to get in a single hallway at the National Institutes of Health. That's why we chose to end it here and say that we've now represented 0.1% of the human genome. And that's as far as we can go in this particular exhibit.